highway run into the midnight sun. Wheels go round and round on my mind. Restless hearts sleep alone tonight, sending all my love along the wire. They say that the road ain't no place to start a family. Right down the line, it's been you and me. And love and a music man ain't always what it's supposed to be. Oh, girl, you stand by me. I'm forever yours, faithfully.
Yeah. A man who could have been sent to prison for years based on claims in a police report was saved by a home surveillance camera. The footage showed he did not attack an officer as claimed in the report. I2 investigator Adam Walser spoke to the Lake Wales man and hears from local leaders who say it's not the first time they've heard complaints about heavy-handed policing in their small town.
I stopped at a stop sign right here on 3rd Street. And I noticed the officer behind me way before I even stopped.
Chris Cordero was driving to Publix February 8th to pick up medicine for his young son when Lake Wales police officer Colt Black pulled him over. Unbeknownst to the officer, a camera across the street captured it all.
I get out the vehicle to ask him what's going on because, you know, he's been following me for a while.
Cordero stands by his car for more than 20 seconds, but Officer Black's report says Cordero immediately exited the driver door and began to charge towards my patrol vehicle.
It says right here in this report, this officer filed in the court.
A South Florida corrections officer finding himself on the wrong side of the law.
He's now facing charges accused of attacking a handcuffed inmate. The apparent abuse caught on camera. Local 10 News reporter Amy Viteri is live in Homestead with the disturbing details. Amy.
According to a report from Port St. Lucie police, the child was riding his bicycle right here at the intersection of Savona Boulevard and Becker Road when that Fort Pierce police officer, who we're told was traveling right here in the right turn lane, hit him in his patrol car. At an intersection just yards from Debbie Johnson's home.
It's a good neighborhood. We've had no issues or anything.
Came an issue she'd never thought she'd hear.
Very scary.
A child riding his bicycle hit by a Fort Pierce police officer in his patrol car. According to this report from Port St. Lucie police.
I was very shocked because we didn't have anything like that to happen out here.
According to the report, the child's mother called Port St. Lucie police, telling them her son was crossing the road at the walk signal at Becker Road and Savona Boulevard when the police car bumper clipped him, knocking him over. She told police the officer in the car did check on her son, offering him a Band-Aid, but then drove away without contacting her, filing a report, or leaving her son with his information.
Your Honor, not enough evidence presented for the jury to find the verdict that they did. They didn't do all the field sobriety examinations that should have been done.
During the trial, it was revealed that Gonzalez was never given a breathalyzer or had her blood drawn. Yet, arresting officer Michael Wagner recorded that she tested above the legal limit of 0.08 in his official report. Wagner claimed it was an honest mistake, but observed what he believed to be intoxication.
I respectfully ask that this court grant the judgment notwithstanding the verdict.
The attorney is asking the judge to use his power to overturn the jury's verdict and acquit the defendant. It's a move rarely seen in the courtroom.
All right. This isn't a purely circumstantial case. And so I'm going to deny the motion for JOA.
It looks like the case is closed, but Judge Schott has other business with Gonzalez.
Now, we have this other case for driving a license suspended.
2 months after her DUI arrest,
he caused her to have her driver's license suspended for at least a few months for nothing. So are you going to null pros that case, or am I going to get mad at you today?
The judge is addressing prosecutor Diana Mears.
Perhaps you can get mad at me, Your Honor, but at this point...
Why wouldn't you? Wait a minute. Did you hear the uncontroverted testimony of this officer?
Your Honor.
Then I want you taking him up on perjury.
Your Honor.
Will you take him up for perjury?
He admitted it was a mistake, Your Honor.
No, but he lied. He lied on a sworn
citation.
Absolutely
not, Your Honor, and that is not true.
I'm dismissing. I am dismissing this charge. No, I'm dismissing the charge.